Hey everyone, this is my first ever decent sized custom Lego ship. It's a container ship that's designed to carry the intermodal containers that I standardized upon that you've probably seen before. You've seen some of these going around on my trains. You've seen some of them on truck trailers. So it's kind of a standard that just works across everything, just like in real life. And I just wanted to get as many of those as possible onto this largest unitary hull that Lego has ever made. This blue one, took the stickers off of it. They were made, the stickers that were on it originally looked good, but they were from that era when Lego stickers would harden and then they would peel and flake and stuff. But the rest of the ship beyond the unitary hull is custom built. Got some details around the edges of it, has some details on the interior, got a couple of anchor windlasses, even though the unitary hull does not have holes for anchors to stick out the sides. Still got the windlasses in there, got the four masts on it. I think that the proportions of the thing look pretty good. Would have been nice to get even more containers on this for sure, but I think given the size constraints, I was able to squeeze a good amount of stuff on there without it being just too compacted. I did have to insert in, kind of cheat a little bit. I used half length containers down here, so kind of a substandard. This is kind of the equivalent in my Lego world to 40 foot intermodal containers. And then these are like 20 foot intermodal containers, you could say. They use the same sort of system, and these ultimately are done in a compatible way. So I've got another one here, so it would just fit those. And you know, if the shipment was not able to have a couple of these 20 foot equivalent ones on there, then you just put something in to kind of act as a dummy one, you know, just to give it a little extra support there to still be able to hold the 40 foot equivalent ones at the front. But see, this all still fits together, so it's kind of like a sub Lego system within there with another standard. This isn't really a large enough thing to have the lashing bridges, but I put some in anyway just to have some additional detail, you know, keep it from being too boring, to keep it from having open space there. I think those actually look pretty good. That's all this stuff in here. Used some Technic bricks to fill in the sides to give it just a little more extra detail inside the hull when it's not completely, you know, fully loaded. And then I got another lashing bridge in between the set right here, and then another one at the back of the rearmost set of containers. This actually works back here. The dinghy holder, the life raft holder or crane. So that's actually able to deploy the thing. So just get this to move out, and then that'll swing out like that. And I can bring these down, not all the way, almost to the surface. Very, very, extremely close to the surface. Very close indeed. So that works out pretty well as well. I think it was important for the safety concerns of the minifigs in my city to actually have that on a ship of this size. I'm not sure if I'll be able to accommodate such a thing on every custom ship that I do, because it really has very, very tight limitations to it. There's a little bit of detailing in front of the superstructure down there, but you can't see it all too well. They actually have, maybe you can see it a little bit better on the other side. Let me bring this around. Back of the superstructure doesn't look quite so good, not quite as interesting, but I guess while I'm up here, you can see some of the stuff up on top, some of the gear. I wanted to use this old, very rare to find in intact shape, old antenna, you know, housetop antenna, but it's not necessarily the most appropriate thing for a ship, but I've had that piece for quite some time and I wanted to use it, so I did. And you know, I got a radar bar up there, you know, some familiar stuff. And I think that the superstructure itself looks pretty good from the outside. It's detailed on the inside as well. I'll show you that in just a minute. But the only place on this entire build where I ran out of pieces was the back, right here, these back corners. So I wanted to use these angled side pieces, but I just didn't have any more. I had five of those and I used four of them, two on either side. So I wish I could have, you know, smoothed this in just a little bit better. That would have made me a little bit more happy. This door opens into nothing. This door actually opens into the lower level here, but the whole top comes off to give you a better look at that. Let me make a little extra room back here. This one's a little bit wedged in there right now. I've been moving this around a bit, but yeah, there are a couple of life preservers and then just some other greebly type stuff in there, as well as another light. You know, I got some lights around the sides and such. So let me go ahead and open up the top, because the roof comes out as an insert to let you see inside the bridge. All this here as one assembly just pops up. And then you can see the interior, which actually has access to a lower level via a ladder. That's all that I was able to get in there. But it works, at least it gives some sort of suggestion of proper access. And it's got a nice console up at the front, a whole row of different instruments and such. You've got the mirrored controls on either side, which I think kind of makes sense to have the two. And that's kind of like the first mate there. And then the captain is over here on this side, just taking a look at what's going on the port. And you can just see his face through the window right there. So that's pretty much it for the upper floor, the upper deck of the bridge. But then all of this also is able to pop up. It's just attached in a couple of points, and that gives you a look at what's down below. So just a small area, but this isn't it. So that guy's just sitting there casually watching TV. He's got an older torso on. It's actually starting to yellow up a little bit, but he's watching some TV, you know, at a little table right there. There's not much else detail to see here, except for, sorry, this is, yeah, there we go. Coffee maker, just a small coffee maker that fits in the corner. It was a slightly different build than I've seen before, but it's kind of weak. You know, it's just really small. It had to fit in that very small space. And I'll show you why it had to fit in that small space. So what I'm gonna do is take this lazy dude out, because he's not performing any function anyway, fold up the table, fold up either chair, and then I need the space of this entire floor to be able to move. So that's why the coffee maker down in this corner needed to clear that. And also needed to leave room for the door, but all this comes up, and then there's an engine room down in there that I'm pretty happy with, which unfortunately you're just not able to see quite as well as I would like. But you know, I got some detailing in there. It comes out to be an inline six-cylinder engine, which actually would make sense, you know, in the real world. And a little more detail to be seen around this side of it as well. Nah, you can't really see quite down in there, unfortunately. The wall is just a little bit too tall to give you a good angle, but the cylinder head and block is simulated by just a couple of plates of height, but there's green behind there, which is a realistic color that you would actually normally see. Now, the smokestack is largely solid inside, just because of the structure and parts usage and such. But yeah, I was able to get, you know, three levels to this thing, so they're all accessible and kind of makes sense. You know, they're believable. So from this side, that's where you can see the necessity of the clearance for the coffee maker in order to be able to get this big old insert for the floor in. And once that's in place, which it is not yet, okay, there we go, get it to settle down. Easily bring the chairs back down, bring the table back down, and just kind of stops itself. And then you can bring back the superstructure, the main portion of the superstructure here, with the ladder that sticks all the way down to the base. That fits on. And then the last thing that goes on top is all the instrumentation and everything up here. So I got all those levels on there, and I'm happy with that. Even though most of the time you're not going to be able to see any of that, I'm happy to actually have it. And it didn't take me too much time to actually do that. You know, there's not too much detail on the outside of this thing to see, given that it's a container ship. It's all about the containers. It's all about the cargo itself. So I wanted to put a little extra time into actually doing the interior the first time around and not waiting for that. So now this gets to sit in my city, back in the designated cargo harbor area. And that was pretty fun. I enjoyed it. So I think I'm actually going to go ahead and make my next ship pretty soon. I don't know if it'll be the very next thing that I do, but I'm kind of feeling good about boat stuff right now. I'm happy with how this one turned out. and I need to do some smaller ones with some other hulls. I actually really like using the pre-built hulls that LEGO has, that, you know, LEGO has already made in the past. So I'll stick to those for the most part for now, even though, you know, making fully custom hulls is a nicer thing to do. It's more impressive, but this is, you know, this is stuff that I'm doing for me. So I have to do what I enjoy the most, which in this case is basing stuff off those nice pre-built hull pieces that LEGO has made. And they've made a lot of different styles of ones over the years that I've liked since the very first one. So a lot of nostalgia built up into that, and being able to use those parts on modern custom builds just brings a lot of happiness to me personally. So that's that for now. Obviously a lot more to be done. I need to make gantry cranes. I need to finish connecting things, warehousing. So much more needs to be done, but it's always great to make progress, which is gonna happen little by little. Hope that you've enjoyed this. I most definitely have enjoyed the process, and I'm glad to have been able to share a finished product with you fairly quickly. So if you have any thoughts about this, feel free to leave your comments down below, positive or negative, hit thumbs up or thumbs down. Either way, whichever is honest feedback is appreciated. Thank you again for watching, and I'll talk to you again soon.